Hi, my name is Colleen Histon, and together with my husband Michael, we have the first and only sheep milk dairy in the state of Maryland. We produce sheep's milk cheeses, and I also make soap with the milk. We raise our own sheep, and we do all of the milking ourselves. So we are what's considered a farmstead operation in doing the entire product from start to finish. The cheeses that I produce are both raw aged cheeses, pasteurized aged cheeses, and fresh cheeses. You can find my cheese at a lot of different locations. We go to farmers markets. Right now we are in the Westminster Farmers Market that's only about 10 minutes from our location, our farm. And we're also down in DC at DuPont Circle every other week. And I'm starting Penn Quarter Market, which just started back up. That's on Thursday evenings. I'll be there tomorrow. And we are at Harford County's Bel Air Market. So I do that every Saturday morning. We are also at the Alani Farmers Market. That's down off of 108 in Montgomery County. We have a couple of other markets that we'll probably be starting up later in the season. My favorite part of this farm, being a cheesemaker, this business, is enjoying doing something on my own, doing something that I am producing that is favorable to other people. I used to work in an office for many, many, many years, just doing a job that I had to do in order to make a living for us to survive. So although the aspect of this is basically the same way, I mean, I'm making a living, producing a product so that we can survive, it's something that I can appreciate, it's something that I can be proud of that I do, and I can be doing it, you know, on my own, in my own, on my own terms. So I can enjoy being on this lovely farm on a lovely day like today, where it's beautiful outside and I could come outside and appreciate that and enjoy that aspect. Favorite cheese? I get asked that question a lot. I get asked what is recommended cheese. So I make a lot of different cheeses, and it's kind of like wine, where I have certain wines that I drink with certain things and certain foods that I eat. But I have so many wonderful cheeses, I have to say. And I guess, you know, if I was going to try to pick something, I have a brand new cheese that I just actually packaged this past week just to taste it, see what it was like. And it's a very young, pasteurized, rinded cheese that has juniper berry, cardamom, and ginger in it. And you can eat the rind, which when my cheeses start to get older and age, the rind definitely has a very distinct flavor. It changes quite a bit from the cheese itself. This rind is so young and so nice that you can just bite into that rind and it's just delicious along with the cheese. Cheese has a great smell with those spices in it. I also have a fresh cheese, my Eucrem, that I love, that it's so versatile. Love it on crackers, love it with jelly on the crackers. And then the third one I'm gonna say that I only make during the milking season is my bloomy rind style. So a couple years ago, I really, really wanted to make a bloomy rind cheese. And to make a bloomy rind, you can't just put it in your aging room and just let it sit. It has to be in a higher moisture environment. It has to have a higher humidity than the other cheeses. So I was challenged with trying to figure out, how am I going to make this cheese successfully? And I did figure out how to do it. And I've been making it now for 2 years. And it's a soft ripened, bloomy style cheese, small individual rounds. And when I first cut it, and it's young, it's only 2 weeks old, very mild, very nice, not stinky like a lot of those cheeses are. And it's really, really edible for me. when it gets older, I have some diehard people that love stinky, nasty cheese. That's not me, but I have a lot of people that like that. So they want to let it sit around for a while and then eat it. So the great thing about that cheese is it starts out one way, and then a few weeks later it changes over time and it becomes something else that other people appreciate. So it can be appreciated both ways. Take the pledge and come visit us at one of our farmers markets that we're in.